we start the season, I could feel we have a very strong bike. Yamaha did a very big effort in end of 99. And in 2000, everything was okay, except I couldn't get the maximum of the bike. I was a little bit slower than Shinya in half part of the championship. Shinya was really fast.
Yeah, I remember I won a fast race South Africa and also Malaysia because the second season in a Grand Prix was more, I was more confident. And of course, I was ready to fight, you know. So that's why I was good to lead him this time.
I think it was after French Grand Prix, I could feel a very good improvement on myself and the feeling I had with the bike, and then I start to improve my level and to reach the level of Nakano. And then it was a strong battle, I remember now. Arrived Mugello, it was I think not half season but a little bit before half season, and
that race I crashed Friday or Saturday, anyway before race I crashed, and my bike was completely broken, and also I was a little bit injured, and after I went to see Dr. Costa, Herbe Poncharal came to see me. He said, sure, Shinya, it's not good to crash, but he said, if you go fast tomorrow, everybody, you know, big surprise, so do your best, he said. So, and the next day, Sunday, I still remember, I was a little bit painful when riding, but I wanted to make a team and everybody surprised, you know, after a big crash.
I was pissed off this race because I lost. I finished second, and it was really nothing to lose the race. And for me, it was very, very high target to win Mugello. It's very mythic circuit, and it was my hope to win, but. But then I could feel I was strong enough now to beat and to fight with Shinya for the title. For sure, the competition was really coming higher and higher every race, every month. But we tried to keep the relationship very, very well for having a very clear championship. And there was a very strong emulation in the team. And then we grew up and we overtake our limits sometimes. We went so far in the race, so far over the limits. We have some very short moments we can share only together, and this we can keep in mind, and we will never forget.
I think we had a good relationship with the team, and the team is like a big family, you know. And we tried to help each other, and I was comfortable with the team.
It was really critical end of season because I was scoring 20 points more than Shinya three rounds to the end. And I tried to finish the championship in Brazil. I tried to close the championship and to win the race because I knew I was strong there, but I pushed too strong, too much at the beginning of the race, and I crashed. and I restarted the race, but it was not for this time. So then we were only, I was only 10 points over Shinya after Brazil, and we came in Motegi, where Shinya is really strong there. So it was very, very hard to fight and to match with Shinya this time.
You know, team is all French people, and he's Olivier is French rider, and I'm Japanese. So if I am always behind him, I can't get anything, you know. So that's why I try to show my potential to even to the team people, team staff. And that's why every race, every lap, I push hard to finish in front of him.
In Australia, it was the winner of the championship was the one who was finished in front of the other. The pressure was really high, I remember, but it was very psychological. Also, we were sharing the same room, you know, we changed in the same room. This time was hard because you need to have some places to rest and to concentrate.
This race I still remember. Before race, already my strategy was to try to, of course, my best, push hard from fast lap. You know, I didn't, pray. Just go straight and we see results, you know.
And the time, the weather was changing a lot, the wind was changing, and was really stressful. And during the race, it was like a dream. It was everything was slowing down. I remember the first lap of the race, Kato tried to overtake me, and I said, no, you cannot overtake me, this is my race. I overtake him again by the inside, and then I joined Nakano, who was leading the race at this time. And we play a little bit in the beginning of the race, then we stop playing, we try to make a big gap with the other to be in a better advantage for the end of the race. And then I tried to study a little bit at Nakano and tried to make a strategy. And I could see easily I was faster than him in the last curve, just before the long straight where the finish line is. And I said, okay, my strategy will be there. I will overtake him on the finish line if my engine can do it.
I said last lap, I said, just one more lap, you know, just I think less 2 minutes. If I push, I can get world champion. I said, just one corner, two more corners.
bet. I do this. It's very risky. I can do it before. I can overtake him before. But he did a very good season, very good race. He deserved it also. I say I bet. I do it. It was really risky. And last curve, last straight.
When it's the last corner, I thought I can get.
I could feel I could do it, but depend of the wind, you never know, because the finish line was really far on the straight. And you never know if you will be just next to him or you overtake him. And God say it will be you this time. I overtake him for a few centimeters.
Finish running, I said somebody, you know, behind me, and I feel somebody behind, and my bike was not pushing enough, and because he was just behind me, and he used my slipstream. So. I saw Olivier like this, you know, and but. Sure, when I see him, I couldn't believe it because almost I was jumping.
But someone was waiting for us in a few corners later, and I saw him with my flag, world champion Olivier Jacque, so I stopped and Shinya go. So happy. It was excellent. Yeah, it was so strong feelings.
I think I did my best, you know. So that's why after race I said, so disappointed. But after I said, I was good, and so that's why I could say congratulations to the Olivier, and also. My father was there. We discussed and about race, and he said, not big problem. It's not doesn't kill me, you know, make me stronger.
We never talked so much about this because I knew he could. I think it was really, really hard for him as well because he's only second. And you never remember the second. So, but I really appreciate his reaction and how he is now and what he's doing in MotoGP is really, really high level.
It's funny because he's a test rider for Kawasaki now. And now, sure, for sure, we can speak more about more things, many things. And. Also, I'd like to say thanks to Albert Poncharal, team manager, and because after race he told me, sure, disappointed race, this last race, but you have a future, you continue to push right today, then you will have a good, you can get something good. So this I still remember, yeah.